lived in New York City for a while, as a matter of fact. I told my mom, I said, Mom, I'm gonna go make it on Broadway. And she said, no way. I said, yeah, you know, like Frank Sinatra, do it my way. Ended up playing music every night in the subway. Now that's a true story. I was a subway musician for about 3 years in New York City. Stand clear of the closing doors, please. 100 times a night. Stand clear of the closing doors, please. Number 6 train, uptown side at Spring Street. That was my stop. And I'd stand right there on the platform with this little guitar right here. And my guitar case open, and hopefully people would come by and put some money on it. And the train would come to the station. Mom, you know what? Remember those old disco records you had that I used to listen to a lot? Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. It's just like that song, you know. Like a jungle sometime, let me get in the high keyboard. Like a jungle sometime, let me get in the high keyboard. Like a jungle. Like a jungle sometime, let me get in the high keyboard. Closing doors, please. From Greenville, North Carolina, to Rocky Mountain, that's where you catch the Amtrak train. Sky high hope, I had open eyes going. I had earth all over my face, yeah. Mama. Well, the new wears on. Time wears on and on. Mama, my roots start showing through. Yes, they do. You know, nobody gives a damn about from where you come from. In New York City, it's all about what they gotta get out of you. That's just how they do it. Spirit guide was going to show up and impart that message of wisdom that would take me to the next level. But I'm here to tell you, no grizzly bear ever showed up in subway. I was the closest thing to it. No jaguar or any of those other fancy spiritual animals ever showed up in it. And I was about to give up, but one day my spirit guide showed up in a very strange form. In the form of Mongolian goat. I mean, it's New York City after all. Anything can happen, and it usually does. So the train comes in the station. The doors open up, and out steps a Mongolian goat herder. He was clad in leather from head to toe. That's right. And he looked at me in my eyes, and he went, ooh. Smell like goats, you know that? okay, I get it now. I've been waiting for you. Let me try to make a sound to play with you. And I put my lips together and you went, and I said, you know what they say about the first time, right? Not always the best. For the second time, I was more prepared. He said, and I said, me. Up in New York City.